हेलो गाइस, दिस इज़ रवि। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द करंट गेन एंड वोल्टेज गेन फॉर दिस आरई मॉडल ऑफ अ फिक्स्ड पास सर्किट। इन दिस सर्किट वी विल सिंप्लीफाई लिटिल बिट। इन द आउटपुट सेक्शन दिस आर नॉट एंड आर सी आर इन द पैरेलल, सो वी कैन राइट दिस इन अ सिंगल फॉर्म एंड दिस होल आउटपुट सर्किट विल बिकम लाइक दिस। In this, the R0 and RC are parallel, so we can write in a simpler form. Now we have to calculate the current gain for the given circuit, and the current gain means output upon input, and current gain means output current upon input current. In this circuit, output current is I0, and the input current is II. So what we have to find, we have to find the current gain, that is I naught upon II. First of all, find out the value of I naught. From this circuit, we can say that I naught is flowing from this load resistance RL, because there is no another circuit beyond this load resistance. So I naught is the current passing through load resistance, and it is then some of the current is passing through this R0 parallel RC, and the total current is passing through IC. So we can say that IC is the sum of the current I0 and the current that is passing through this resistance. So according to the current divider rule, we can write the value of I0. I0 is equals to IC into this resistance upon R0 parallel RC plus RL. So it has been written that I0 is equals to IC R0 parallel RC upon R0 parallel RC plus RL. And if we apply a same current divider rule at the input section, so we can write the value of IB. IB can be written as, the value of IB is equals to II into RB upon RB plus beta plus 1 RE. So we can write this equation. It has been written IB is equals to II into RB upon RB plus beta plus 1 RE. Then we are putting this, the value of I naught, into our general equation. General equation is current gain AI is equals to I naught upon II. In place of I naught, we place this equation. IC R0 parallel RC upon R0 parallel RC plus RL, it has been written. In denominator, we have to put II. I have put this II. In the numerator, we can say that IC is equals to beta IB from the current gain relationship. Beta is equals to IC upon IB. So we can write IC is equals to beta IB. We can replace this in this equation. And from this, in place of IB, we have put the value of this IB from this equation and cancel out the II. So we get the relation of the current gain is beta in multiplication of RB upon RB plus beta plus 1 in brackets RE, and another bracket R0 parallel RC upon R0 parallel RC plus RL. So there are two cases in this current gain equation. We have taken a first approximation that if R0 is greater than equals to 10 times RC, then R0 parallel RC should be equals to RC. We can see that if R0 means this R0 parallel RC, if R0 is greater than 10 times RC, then this equation we can neglect this RC as compared to R0. If we neglect this, then this R0 will cancel out and whole expression will equals to the RC. So that has, it has been written. Then put this approximation in our equation of the current gain that we have find earlier. So by putting this relation, In this, the only second term will be changed. In place of this R naught parallel RC, we can replace it with RC. In denominator also, this will become RC plus RL. So this equation we will get by considering this assumption. In the second assumption, if the value of base resistance and the collector resistance is very high, or we can say that it is approximately infinity, so we can say that R naught will be less than with respect to RC. So in this general equation, we can say that RC is greater than R naught. According to this assumption, RC is infinite, so we can neglect the value of R naught in the denominator. Only RC term will be appear in the denominator, and this RC will cancel out, and only R naught will appear for this expression. And by putting this equation, this assumption in our general equation, we can say that this R naught parallel RC will become R naught, and this R naught parallel RC become R naught. So we got this equation R naught upon R naught plus RL, and in this RV is also very high. In the second assumption, we have assumed RB is also very high, its value is infinite. So we can neglect this beta plus 1 RE as compared to RB. So this will be neglected, and RB term will cancel out in this equation. And finally, we got this equation. This value of current gain AI is equals to beta R naught upon R naught plus RL. There is another term named as overall current gain. Overall current gain means output current this I naught upon this input current that is flowing in the circuit due to Vs. So we can say that Is is the input current that flows due to Vs. So the overall current gain will be I output upon Is. This current gain is same as we have obtained in the S parameter section. So this will refer from that part. Now next we have to find the voltage gain. In the voltage gain means it is the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage from this circuit. If we apply KVL into this output loop, then what we will get the equation. We know that current is flowing from positive to negative. Then from this relation, we can write the KVL equation. For that, we will get minus of I naught into RL minus V output is equals to 0. So V output is equals to minus I naught into RL. So for the voltage gain, I have written V output is equals to minus I naught into RL. For I naught, this from the circuit is the current passing through this load resistance. So the value of I naught can be written in terms of IC by using current divider rule. This will become I naught is equals to IC into this resistance R naught parallel RC upon R naught parallel RC plus RL. This has been written. Just go through one more time. So this by applying current divider rule, I have written I naught is equals to IC into this resistance. In denominator, sum of the resistances, this and this, it has been written. And the value of IC can be obtained by using current gain beta. IC is equals to beta IB. In place of IC, I have placed beta IB. This beta IB. R naught parallel RC upon R naught parallel RC plus RL. So from this equation of I naught, the value of I naught is put it into the value of V naught by putting this value in place of I naughts. We will get this equation. AV is equals to output voltage upon input voltage minus beta IV R naught parallel RC upon R naught parallel RC plus RL minus multiplication of RL. From the value of VI can be obtained from the input section of the circuit. In this input section, we can write the value of VI. VI is the voltage between the node 1 and 1 dash. These two resistances are in parallel, so the value of VI can be written as current into resistance. This current is IB and this resistance is beta plus 1 RE. So it has been written voltage is equals to this is current and this total is your resistance. So the value of VI is put it into the voltage gain equation by putting this equation and simplifying this equation, we will get the value of voltage gain is minus beta upon beta plus 1 in brackets RE in brackets then R naught parallel RC parallel RL. These all the three resistances are in parallel, so we can simply write this in the form of this equation. In this voltage gain topic, we have taken the three cases. In the first case, if beta plus 1 is approximately equals to beta because the value of beta is much greater than 1, so we can replace the value of beta plus 1 with this beta. This by putting this assumption in this voltage gain equation, in denominator we will replace beta plus 1 with the beta and this beta beta will cancel out and we will obtain this equation for the voltage gain. In this AV is equals to minus R naught parallel RC parallel RL upon RE emitter resistance. In the second case, if R naught is greater than equals to 10 times RC, then this voltage gain will become minus RC parallel RL upon RE. This will come from the relation. This AV is equals to minus of R naught parallel RC parallel RL upon RE. When we are putting this in the parallel, then we will get this type of relation in the basics of parallel resistance question equivalent circuit. We will get this expression when R1 parallel R2 parallel R3. By solving this equation, if R1 is equals to R0, R2 is equals to RC and R3 is equals to RL, by putting this assumption R0 greater than equals to 10 times RC, then in the denominator we will get only two terms in which R0 is common. If we take R0 common and in numerator and denominator R0 will cancel out, we will get only RC and RL. From this we can say that RC and RL are parallel. So from that equation we will get this RC parallel RL upon RE. Now in the next case, if RL is infinite, then by putting RL is infinity in this above equation, we will get minus RC upon RE. Here one thing we have to notice that a negative sign is in the voltage gain. In the common emitter configuration, we have seen that the output is 180 degree out of phase with respect to input. So this negative sign shows the 180 degree phase shift of the input. Thank you guys.